Did you know that centuries ago, people found clever ways to produce light and heat without using firewood? They created oil and alcohol lamps, simple yet brilliant inventions that changed daily life. Today, we'll go even further. I'll show you several unique burner ideas and heat-powered DIY projects you can easily make at home. These builds are simple, effective, and surprisingly smart. Some might even blow your mind. For our first idea, you'll need a regular aluminum can, Coca-Cola, Fanta, or even that weird soda no one drinks, but somehow still ended up in your fridge. Cut the can in half. Carefully, not like in an action movie, but like a true DIY master. Smooth out the bottom with scissors so it stands nice and steady. Then cut out three little triangles, and just like that, you've got a tiny tripod stand. Almost looks like something from a fancy designer shop, but hey, this one's free. Now for the magic. Place a small candle underneath, and on top, add a few drops of essential oil, lavender, orange, mint, whatever scent lifts your mood. And in just a few seconds, voila. You've got yourself a homemade aroma lamp. It not only fills the room with cozy vibes and a lovely scent, but is perfect for relaxing, meditating, or simply making your space smell better than a new car. The second idea is even simpler and perhaps more brilliant than the first. Using an ordinary empty tin can, you can recreate an authentic 19th century lantern. These kinds of designs were quite popular back in the day, though they looked a bit different. We'll need a tin can and a paraffin candle. First, mark the diameter of the candle, then carefully cut out a hole using a knife or any other suitable tool. Next, let's add a bit of retro flair. Bend some wire to make a simple handle. Insert the candle into the hole, and just like that, you've got a near-perfect replica of a lantern from the days before electricity. After all, it wasn't until 1879 that Thomas Edison invented the first practical electric light bulb. And long before that, in 1799, Italian scientist Alessandro Volta created the very first source of electrical energy, the so-called voltaic pile. It's widely considered the true beginning of electricity as we know it. What if I told you that a tiny lip balm container could be turned into a fully working mini burner? First, let's open this legendary container, the kind people say is impossible to open. But hey, we're DIYers. Impossible is just another word for fun challenge. Yup, it runs on alcohol and looks just like a gas stove, only bite-sized. Grab a super thin drill bit, around 1 millimeter, and carefully make small holes all around the lid. The more precise you are, the cooler the flame will look. Next, stuff in some medical gauze or natural cotton fabric. Pour in a little clean medical alcohol and seal it up. Boom. Boom, your mini burner is ready to go. It'll run for about 10 minutes on a single fill. Just enough to warm up some coffee, heat a little soup, or impress your friends with this pocket-sized engineering marvel. Portable, playful, and brilliantly simple. Gotta love it. This old broken light bulb adapter, most people would toss it straight in the trash. But not me. I see potential in every piece of so-called junk. So why not turn it, along with an old burned-out bulb, into a stylish little oil or alcohol lamp? I admit it, I'm a bit of a collector of creative clutter. But hey, that's how genius ideas are born. First, let's take apart the bulb socket. It has this shiny gold finish. Looks almost fancy. Maybe it's real gold? Yeah, probably not. But we can dream. Next, grab an old incandescent bulb. Time for a bit of DIY magic. Cover it with a tissue, say some magic words, and poof! It's suddenly empty, with a perfect hole on top. Okay, no actual sorcery involved. I removed the insides earlier and drilled the opening with a grinding stone. Come on, it looked cool, right? And this little guy right here, is going to be our fuel tank. Well, technically just a container, but let's call it what it feels like, a power unit for our mini burner. Before we fill it up, there's an important step. We need to drill a few holes in the lid. Now don't go full oil rig mode. Take it slow and neat. These holes are essential. They'll let vapor escape or allow a wick through, depending on your setup. So, with just a few simple tweaks, this tiny container is about to become the heart of our homemade burner. Now for the finishing touch. Let's tighten those two little screws and lock that shiny golden part in place. Okay, maybe it's not real gold, but hey, it definitely looks like something straight out of a steampunk treasure chest. A couple of turns, and voila, it's locked in solid like it was built in a factory, but way cooler. An oil lamp without a wick is like a teapot without a lid. Looks nice, but doesn't really work. So let's make a wick. All you need is a strip of 100% cotton, a piece of an old t-shirt, some natural string, or any pure cotton fabric. Just make sure it's not synthetic. Synthetic fibers don't burn, they melt. And trust me, melted plastic is not the vibe we're going for. So go grab that worn-out cotton shirt and let's turn it into something useful. The oil burner is ready to shine. We fill it up with regular sunflower oil. Yes, the same kind your grandma uses to make her legendary pancakes. Close the lid and flip the container upside down to let the wick soak up the oil for the first ignition. Now comes the magic moment. Light the wick. The flame appears gently, confidently, like it's saying, "I'm ready to warm this world." But to make things as safe as possible, we screw in the light bulb on top. And that bulb isn't just for looks. It's your flame guard. No curious fingers or sneaky cats will knock it over or accidentally touch the flame. Safety first, DIY style. In the end, you've got a real piece of design art. Golden, stylish, and impressive. With a lamp like this, you're not just creating a cozy vibe, you're making a statement. Wow, you made this yourself? Can you make me one too? Sure, but only after you drink some tea and hold the cat.